Looking good. Looks like we're ready to go. Whew. Hello, everyone, and Happy New Year. Nerui here. It's time for the first official stream of the new year. So, as promised, we are going to start Bioshock 2.
Would you? Well, actually, this isn't "would you kindly" anymore.
Nope. "Would you kindly" is already dead and rotting at this point.
It's still last season.
Welcome, nickname. Looks like we have an Orskin and a Varna here too.
Yeah, we were we were playing some Kawa Shoujo, so we just came over to join you because you're starting. Bioshock 2 now, eh?
Yep.
Indeed. Indeed, we just got our ass murdered. Or...
Yeah, we got accidentally thrown off the roof by our drunk buddy.
Oh dear.
We got drunk on 12-year-old single malt whiskey, and we were talking with our conspiracy nutcase buddy, Kenji.
Walt Miski, huh? You really have been drinking it.
Oh, yeah.
Well, before that, we had some fun with our girlfriend.
Yep, we completed the Emmy arc, which was pretty good.
Yeah.
So, It's an interesting game. I think you'd probably enjoy that one, Nene.
We'll have to see whether or not I get a chance to play that.
Yep, it's a free one in a ways.
For now. A time to head back under the waves.
Oh, yes.
Under the sea.
Gonna go with medium.
So, are we gonna do a rivet dumb gun only playthrough?
Or,
I can already hear Nay going, "No, let's not do that."
I mean, you could always do the drill.
I mean, yeah, drill only is a fun one, but
I'm gonna try and vary it up.
Yes, that's the best way.
Honestly,
to do
that's
it.
The.
The big daddy now.
Oh, yes. Yep, you're playing as Delta.
You're just taking your daughter out on a walk.
Oh, yeah. I mean, we're back in the heyday of,
Rapture.
Of Rapture now, actually. Actually,
yeah, no, it is, because,
actually, we're technically at the end, we're near the end of the heyday, really. Because this is during the Civil War, I think.
Close enough. Because I believe it said, Delta was dead for a bit.
Oh, wait, he was dead for a while.
I mean, you have to realize, if you think about souls and all that, if all that exists in this universe, you'd be like, I just imagine you just coming back like, Jesus Christ, what the hell?
Yep, and here we go. Here's an example.
I love that moment. I like how he thinks he could do something with that pipe.
There we are. He's perfectly safe now. This is not your daughter. Do you understand? Her name is Eleanor, and she is mine. Now, kneel, please. Remove your helmet.
Sophia, that bitch.
Now, take the pistol. Place it against your head.
Since he's an Alpha series, he's can actually.
Yep.
I believe the helmets were bonded onto them before.
It's something like that.
No, well, that's certainly an opening.
Yep, that's the opening.
Mm-hmm. 10 years later.
Yep.
I believe this is like 5 years, give or take, after the first game.
Something like that. It is at least a few years after it. Because it's long enough for the little sisters to become big sisters.
Fair point.
Yeah, they don't build them like me much anymore.
Johnny topside.
Yep.
Which technically is just technically a nickname if you think about it. I don't think that you.
It was a nickname given to him.
Yeah.
Certainly an upgrade from the first game, going from your primary melee weapon being a wrench to a big ass honking drill.
Yep, which requires fuel. Mm-hmm.
But you can still hit people with it if you don't.
Oh, definitely. It's only really for like the big old charge attacks you need fuel for.
And it's certainly an upgrade from the first one, where you can still see the outline of the map. Here, it's only you unveil the map as you come across it.
Exactly.
Which makes planning your excursions a little bit more challenging.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, and I see they got the ammo banditos and the other vending machines split up on the map for now. That's good.
Oh, yeah, that is a huge. Excuse me. A huge quality of life improvement right there.
Oh, definitely, because before they just had all the vending machines under the same label, and like, I really need an ammo bandito, I don't need a normal vending machine, they only have like certain ammo types in there. Let's see, do you know about the little, like, hidden things when it comes to you being out in the water?
It's been a while since I've played Bioshock 2, and I haven't played 2 nearly as much as I've played 1.
Okay, well, there's a thing out, when you're out in, like, the watery sections, keep an eye out for them because you can actually collect the sea slugs that are embedded in the stomachs of the little sisters. You can actually find the native slugs outside. There's a certain number of them in total, so they're just added atom reserves you can pick up.
Good to know. I don't think I ever came across that when I played it last.
Yep, yeah, you're looking for the glowing red slugs. But
I do remember that too.
They get very sneaky with where they poke them because, I mean, they are a major resource. I mean, you only get so much at them. But yeah, they're definitely worth it if you can find them.
So basically, if I find myself going out for a casual stroll outside, keep my eyes peeled for anything red.
Yep. Like I said, they're going to be very... I think it's like a spot on them is like glowing red. Like, it's very noticeable when you do see one. But they do like to be very sneaky with where they're poked, though.
Yeah, And once again, if you're in an underwater city and it's raining, that's kind of a bit of a bad thing.
Oh, I mean, just case in point, back to the first audio log you pick up.
You know, I think that's why she said that.
Yeah. Because like I said, like what Buddy said, you know, the moment Rapture starts flooding, it's never going to stop.
They're my beans!
We got our first medkit and Eve hypo, that's good.
I guess you can just call this adventure if Nay likes her beans.
I mean, if she played Katawa, she'd have a lot of beans to choose from. Apparently everyone in that game is modeled after Suno's personality.
Yeah. It's weird.
Or aspects of her personality.
It's kind of weird. And one of the girls even has a hair color.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, pink hair is kind of a bit of a trope in a lot of anime.
Oh, it is. And she's the one that also has the drill pigtails, too.
You know there's a door with a key code on it?
If you go back. You passed by one. Although I don't think she found a key code yet for it.
Usually you can see through the door sometimes, if I remember correctly. It could have been right on the other side.
Ah.
Yeah.
Aha.
Yep. See?
There it is.
And another thing, the thing is the quality of life here. If you spine the code, it keeps gives you a little note. So you don't have to worry about going back and looking it up again.
That's cool. And they really changed the way you do hacking in this game.
Yep.
My husband is such a perfect idiot.
Now it's a reaction test rather than you trying to do fluid dynamics.
It was an old game called Pipes.
Yep, Pipe Dream, I believe, is another thing that they call it. Or at least they call that style of gameplay. I mean, it was fun to do, especially if you dialed yourself into the various tonics to like really make hacking really powerful.
You know, I also just realized, I think that girl was in, like, a sauna when you fall out or something. It
yep,
like
she was in a sauna.
Ouch.
Yeah, basically got boiled to death.
Yep. But yeah, so now you know that there's a hidden atom out there you can pick up. Ew, and I'm guessing this will be Electrobot.
Sleeping for such a long time, and Eleanor has missed you. Find her and you'll be all better.
Daddy! Yoink!
Yep, yoinkage.
Yep, the big sister.
Like I said, Johnny takes the plasma. It's much better than Jack does, it seems, at times.
Well, think about it. Johnny's been enhanced so much now, he probably doesn't feel it as much as what Jack did, because at the end of the day, even after all the genetic tinkering he had, Jack was still just a purebred human.
True.
Whereas Delta's undergone a lot of, like, augmentations to himself.
Mental, too, so
I mean, he is basically a prototype Big Daddy.
Yep, he is the original.
Well, Delta, I believe, would be 4, I think, isn't it? Delta, Alpha, Omega. Actually,
Actually, Delta would be Alpha, Beta, Delta, Gamma.
Oh, yeah. Actually, do you have the DLC for this, the Thinker? Thinker, this is called.
Not sure. There we go, lights on.
But yeah.
At last, a signal.
I believe you play subject Sigma.
Listen,
and,
my name, it is Tannenbaum. I know who you are, and I am in much need of your help. Please, find me in the Atlantic Express train station.
And we're teaming up with Tannenbaum again.
Yep. I mean, it's perfect, of course. She's just trying to right the wrong she's done.
I think we've been...
Well, in this case specifically, she basically wants to...
My daughter, Eleanor.
Get the little sisters, because these are just kids that have been kidnapped.
Yeah, because Blam sent a lot of people out there now to steal a bunch of kids to make more little sisters out of. Because all the original little sisters have now become big sisters.
Or taken up to the surface.
Yep, either.
But the price of revolution is always dear. If we are patient with her...
Oh yeah, toilet whiskey.
Come to us. Hey, nothing wrong with that. Just stay away from ledges and drunk buddies for yourselves.
Indeed.
Another thing you have to enjoy.
Taste of Adam in weeks.
Being able to have both your plasmid and your weapon equipped simultaneously.
Oh, exactly.
I love that.
Remember. You are not alone.
Think one thing about leader, we've had like I think five protagonists for Bioshock series.
Jack, Sigma, Delta.
Infinite.
Well, I mean, Infinite, you were just playing as Booker.
Not in one of the DLCs, you actually played as Elizabeth.
Oh shit, you did, okay. So then yeah, we've had five.
Five?
Yeah,
games.
Infinite is one that I'm still pretty loose on the all the ins and outs on, especially when it comes to DLCs for it. But I do know like the whole like shtick when it comes to that game.
Yeah, and like with the whole multi travel type of blah blah blah, you know. I'm just counting that as one person.
Yeah. Hold it. Ah, the rabbit gun.
I'm trying to actually remember to use the ADS for some of these things, since I'm not exactly the best of shots.
No worries.
Smooth. It's always kind of fun to imagine, like, why the hell they were carrying a random amount of rivets on them.
Well, think about it. There's probably enough dead Big Daddies out there. There's probably a lot of that salvage out there.
True.
Oh, hey, a wrench.
Also, I think I saw that on the poster. Did you see the name on the poster? I think that was the doc from the first game.
Yeah, that... Yeah, him.
Oh, yes, Dr. Steinman.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep, I thought I saw that. According to him, you're hideous. I don't think a hideous nay.
Simon's sense of beauty is kind of skewed.
Indeed.
Rapture.
This is where that thing took my poor baby girl. From what I saw in the sub, most of the city's in ruins. But there were lights here and there. And shapes moving. I'm rambling, scared, I guess. But maybe, if I find this Dr. Lamb I keep hearing over the PA, I'll find Cindy too.
Oh, God damn it! Someone get the nurse!
Headshot.
This is rather interesting to imagine, like, how much of this is him just acting on his programming and art programming, and how much of this is actually him.
I mean, with Tenenbaum in the picture, I can see her having done some things to alleviate some of Delta's programming.
Yeah.
Meek's sister doesn't want you playing with me.
I don't know much of the story here, this, but like, leading up to this game, there was like a something about Meek got detective's daughter who was kidnapped.
Yep.
You do actually encounter them.
Yeah, because they did end up getting to her.
Yeah, and they agreed to become a big daddy to be with the kid.
Yep.
Oh, right, they changed the button to apply the health pack.
Yeah, it's now a directional button.
Yeah, because he turned the B button into a melee.
This yep.
Is Dr. Yeah. Sophia yeah. Originally, there's supposed to only be one big sister. Remember, big sister is always watching. Which I think it might have only been Eleanor originally. I think they changed it so you're not knowing, like, you know, it wouldn't be as much fun if you knew the enemy was always going to get away.
Exactly.
Can you imagine how this looks to other people just seeing a big daddy just like rummaging through the trash cans? So wrong, now I'm just pitching a big daddy, like Subject Delta, just with your pink hair. You just see a big daddy, but it's got like long pink hair. I mean, I know, you probably could be, that could probably work for a big sister, but in gameplay wise, I find myself seeking a respite from
my vacation. Fine. She deems it necessary. Gotta loot everything.
Oh, yes.
Dissolve into an endless like, Eleanor is watching. Daughter, if you're watching this, don't forget to take anything that isn't nailed down when you're on an adventure. For whom work
is our wage. Important adventuring survival skills.
Indeed, you're just teaching your daughter.
Exactly. Mm. You never know when you're going to need an extra potion or health kit.
Exactly.
Kleptomania saves lives.
You hear that, Eleanor? I know you're watching somehow.
Thank you. some water. Good chance, a good spot to get some easy kills.
Holy.
Or just flood everything.
I still love that moment where in the opening when you just like punch down on that guy.
Yeah, superhero landing with padding.
So, I'm drowning. Oh wait, I have a helmet on.
Yeah, there are any splicers in here. They're dead now.
I remember what was said. I think I see one to the right. Maybe it could have been a light on the wall. And I keep forgetting there's a delay.
Yeah, probably wouldn't be any inside of here, because it's just the building itself that's split, but once we get outside...
Yep, when it's your side.
So, gotta walk outside past all the debris.
In that suit, even the ocean cannot harm you. This is good. But Rapture is the death of many great men. Alone, you will not last long. You can still reach the train station. Find me there.
Hi, Carol.
Hi.
Hi, Carol.
Boop.
Yes. Here we are with the big nay.
All right,
big nady.
Last entry. Lizzie and I. We
big,
found a sphere.
Big
we're going
dad
home.
Nay.
Ain't that right, baby? Next stop, top
big
side.
Mama.
Oh, I love you.
I mean, that works too.
It's you who saved us, Sammy.
Better than...
It's you, Button.
Since the big sisters are technically the Annie.
What's that sound?
Enemy, so I guess instead of Johnny topside, it's Jamie topside.
Not seeing anything that looks really glowy red or worm-like. See, kind of these red bits of. I'm not sure. Some kind of sea foliage.
It's a good thing you're not wearing socks, because they'd be soaked.
I mean, considering that you're you're inside this big ass suit, it'd probably be soaked anyway, just because. I'd imagine a suit like this can get hot.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Ugh. Just imagine just how stinky the inside of the suit must be just from that sweaty foot smell for however many years this particular Big Daddy has been Big Daddy.
Good point.
I'd rather not.
And then there's the new Big Daddies. I think there's technically there's two new types, I think, in general, but I think, there's three new types in this game, technically the Alphas were the first.
So, new to you.
Yeah.
Well, that's one thing is you can explain anything as being Jack did not encounter.
True.
Well, yeah, because we're also going into sections that Jack never even went to.
Yeah, like I said, I don't think any alphas were active probably during the time Jack was down here. Or any of the alpha series.
Eve hypo. I'm probably also thinking that considering that we haven't gotten Adam for the first time yet, there might not be any this one stretch because
that's a good point.
Yeah, we haven't been introduced to the concept of Adam as a mechanic yet.
Ooh, whale bones.
least we hope they're whale bones.
I don't want to see a drugged out. Yes, I wanted to see a ghoul whale in a Fallout 4 and stuff like that. But I don't want to see a whale jacked up on Adam and Eve. I don't think we want to see a whale shooting electricity or a whale beehive.
No.
Now that's an interesting first view of the city, going into it from literally walking out in the middle of the ocean.
Ooh. See, I told you colossal squids exist.
One wonders at the logistics behind the construction of the place.
Yeah.
They go into it in a little bit of detail in the book.
I think they mention that big guys were, aside from the little sister thing, also used in construction.
They were involved in general maintenance.
Well, the suits, it wasn't until later that they were, when it became necessary to protect the little sisters.
Yeah, during the Civil War when they had to start protecting them because just the sheer number of little sisters being attacked and they needed the protectors, and that's where the line of Big Daddies came from.
As the little one said you would. Come upstairs to the ticket booth, and I will offer what I know of you.
Oh. They do show the areas. It's just that area was just really small. That's good to know. Excellent. So at the moment, I can only carry a total of 60 rivets, huh?
I'll take 3 this time. Do you understand that? 3. You think I'm
headshot.
Now most who survive are like this. Splicers. They're drug addicts. Vicious animals.
Shut. And a few times they're like, so, who survived any mostly? Drug addicts?
You can sometimes trick the security system into opening a door, but you must have the proper tool.
What's a... drug addicts? Drugs give you superpowers. That reminds me of Snow Flame, if you ever heard of that.
And there's the hack tool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think I missed the blue bonus on that one.
We will be reborn.
What good is the moonlight? That silvery moonlight that shines way, way up above. Yeah, I walk with the shadows. But where is that gal that I like?
Stop ignoring this!
This is Dr. Sophia Lamb. Andrew Ryan is dead, but the tyrant dwells within us all. Remember, we reject the gene. We reject the self. We reject the tyrant.
Money.
I'm told that the people grow tense and isolated in the absence of the sun. Now they clamor for a psychiatrist. They miss the state.
I like
it.
Whoever enters wartime seizure. You know, I'm actually gonna look that up now.
Or the Cheka police vanishing them in the night? Said to be the foremost practitioner in her field. Fine. If she can quiet the rattling of the Great Chain's weakest links, I will leave her to it.
Okay, great. I can't see a thing.
I know you. That symbol on your hand marks you a dead man. 10 years, Subject Delta, since I watched you put a gun to your head and pull the trigger. But take heart. Out of your pain, paradise was born.
Wow, anyway, Ryan's voice actor has been in a lot of things.
But your suffering is over now. These
men
will ease your burden. Please understand that like all I have done, this is an act of love.
It is
Sophia. Oh wow, Andrew Ryan
has found you.
General Scar from Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy.
Well, that's one way to cool off. Okay.
Oh, whoa. Andrew Ryan's Raz's father's voice in Psychonauts.
Holy crap.
I know, right? I think it looks good. I've seen a trailer for Judas, which I basically am at the moment just referring to as Bioshock space.
Oh right, that game. Yeah, I think I did. I think isn't that that from kind of the same people?
Maybe.
Now you know of the enemy we share, Sophia Lem. The camera in your helmet allows me to watch through your eyes and help you to fight.
Oh yeah, it's Ken Levine's first game since Bioshock Infinite Barrel. Let's see.
So it basically is the next Bioshock.
Yeah, so I guess it is like Space Bioshock.
Sense of direction. Night chamber.
Careful, security cameras belong to them. But if you are clever, they can be made to serve you.
Oh, fishman is curious.
Find the man of the house. Red. That's it. Now I gotta waste time on the wind.
Maybe.
Think you got
I gotta get up to something.
That awful roof.
I am thorough. Yep. That's one thing that seems like a little bit of a downgrade is that in the first one you can carry up to 9 med packs and hypos. Now you can only hold 5.
To toy with you like that ever again. This plasmid is for you. If I'm right, you can use it now. Please, find me.
Throw objects at foes. You can even catch grenades and throw them back.
Eve hypos in those suits.
Stupid machine!
Say to that guy about his take on the quote unquote private vehicle craze.
Can't really have him down in Rapture.
These people are hooked on some kind of genetic wonder drug called Adam. I've read the word splicer scribbled on walls like a warning. One of them cornered me and Christ, his face! I had a gun, but I choked. And then out of nowhere, we both heard this singing. And he took off like hell on wheels.
Sophia Lam is using the splicers against you. Most big daddies are like her slaves. Guarding the little ones. But someone has awakened you. I know of your bond with Eleanor Delta. To save yourself, you will come for her. But Eleanor has a destiny, one you cannot share. There is no place for you in paradise.
White is not black, Dr. Lam. Down is not up, and straw is not gold. Look around you. Rapture is no miracle. It is a product of reason. Impossible unless one and one are two, and A equates to A.
And yet, alone, each man is a prisoner to bias. Dream, delusion, or the pain of a phantom limb. To one man, they are as real as rain. Reality is consensus, and the people are losing faith. Take a walk, Andrew. It is raining in Rapture, and you have simply chosen not to notice.
All those health items now.
In ethical psychiatry, we must account for the role of evolution. Depression, fits of panic, sexual pathos, all responses to ancient selection pressure. The irony is that this theory is why Ryan's people invited me here. They mistake my study of natural law for the worship of competition. Remember, Eleanor, one must know the beast before it can be slain.
One could argue she has a point. Their knowledge is power, after all.
True.
I mean, I don't play that much of it, but it's like kind of like with the Monster Hunter series. Your hunts can go a whole lot better if you understand what your hunting is like and how to bring it down good. Rather than just going in there haphazardly and just whacking away and hoping you'll bring it down.
I'm back.
Welcome back.
Quickly, head for the elevator.
Yeah.
say quick, but I'm still gonna take my time to do it.
Remember, you're doing this, you're just doing this for your daughter. Totally, you're just teaching her a lesson. That's the only reason. Really?
Without all this, I'd find myself woefully short on supplies and ammo.
Come on,
now, here is what the children tell me. You are a very old Big Daddy, bonded for life to a single little one. When you are apart for too long, your body begins to shut down like a coma. As long as the girl is in the Rapture, you are trapped here as well. The name of your little one is Eleanor Lamb, daughter of Sophia. She is kept at Fontaine Futuristics on the other side of the city. You must go there and save her before it is too late.
Trying to set them off, I can just pick them up. What's the habit from the trap trap bolts in number one?
Yeah, good.
Mind if I do? Won't see much. I'm much more in there until I get more weapons.
I used to be insane. I did.
Don't you believe me? I've got my limit.
Thank you.
Here, in the ticket booth. Press the button so we can speak face to face. You see? This is why I must fight Sophia Lamb. She is using the new little ones for something. And I have returned to rescue them. If I do not, more children will die for my sins. And the Rapture nightmare, it will repeat forever. Now, we must talk.
Citizens of Rapture, this is Subject Delta. Behind that mask hides an enemy of the people, without soul or sympathy. It is a beast apart, and as family, we must tear out its jaw and drive it back into the sea.
Lamb will take this place apart to find you. Please hold back the splicers until we escape.
We didn't want to be good because of the swells. But it 2 weeks from that volumes things grow and a flat back in.
Varna?
I get a little feedback there.
Sorry to start watching the video.
No worries.
Thank you. Now I must leave you, and I am sorry for this, but there are others I must help before the city drowns. This man Sinclair, he is an ally, and will guide you to Eleanor. Goodbye, Herr Delta, and good luck.
Well, look at you. A bona fide knight in armor, complete with iron horse. The name's Augustus Sinclair, sport. Esquire. Old Tannenbaum and I share an interest in the old Fontaine building, the very same place you'll find Eleanor Lamb. I think you and I can do business. Take the train to Ryan Amusements. I'll see you shortly.
That was certainly quite the welcome.
Indeed.
And that is more or less the first full level. Not including the tutorial,
So, are we doing full game, full stream?
Well, not gonna go. There's no way I can get through the entirety of this of the game in just a single stream.
I was about to say that's a bit much, nay. that would be, technically that would be a long stream.
Yeah. Gotta try and go at least two full levels. Similar to how I was doing with Bioshock 1.
Nice.
Because, yeah. I mean, yesterday's stream, that was a super long one, for me at least. But that was also a special event stream as well.
Did you get your thing?
I was only able to locate 38 out of the 50 security drones I needed.
Oof.
But I'm thinking that, I still want to get the dog on screen, so I decided I'm going to go and get the rest of the security drones off stream and have a special bonus stream where I can just run the Seraph station again and go get the dog.
Good for you.
Because all the, seven and a half hour stream, I kind of want to have that be end with actually having a show on stream
the brakes
game,
unless you're aiming to dash yourself against that glacier. Maybe
it ends up being a bit of a shorter one.
Oh, nothing wrong with that.
As you can see, Chief, the station here is iced over. To reach Eleanor Lamb at Fontaine headquarters, we'll have to clear the way. Now, in order to melt that ice, you'll need a plasmid like a handful of hellfire. We used to sell a fine old product called Incinerate in the amusement park up yonder.
I like
Go on and find a way in. I've already been on all the rides.
You saw the Swift comment?
Yes. Castle Crashers was a good game.
Oh, it was. I mean, it's a fun little romp for anyone to play through.
Oh, yeah. I think I got it on Steam. My knight of choice was the Pink Knight.
Me, I went with green. I was the poison boy.
I was the candy and rainbows.
Yeah.
No, I've actually never played Castle Crashers.
Ah.
Ooh, you're in for a treat if you ever do.
Now. I need the fire to get that stuff.
Yep.
Cloud! Fucking Cloud! You think you're so funny! Let's fix your face, baby!
A single little sister on this level.
Yep.
It's definitely been a while since I've really played Bioshock 2, so a good chunk of this I don't really remember because I haven't played it nearly as much as I played the original.
No worries.
You're a rare old model, son. Alpha Series, I believe. Now, Rapture's full of scientific wonderments just like you. And if we can sell them to the world at my price, well, curing your condition ought to be a cakewalk. Once we find Eleanor, the sky's the limit.
There's a few familiar sights. Some of the old weapons.
Yep.
And giving us a power to the people station a lot earlier.
Yep. So what will you upgrade?
Let's see. that's another thing they've had here. Because once you get both of the upgrades to one of your weapons, you can then get a special bonus third upgrade.
Yep.
Because, for example, the drill gets fuel efficiency and increases damage, and then a reflector.
Yep. It's an interesting setup, for sure.
Yep. Rivet gun damage, clip size, then a rivet gun heat upgrade.
Yep. Every single bolt is going to be heated up.
I think we go with a rivet gun damage first.
Not a bad idea. And I do love the cosmetic additions for each upgrade.
That is one thing that is very fun about this game series, how they actually show you how your weapon is upgraded.
Yep. And some of them can be very dramatic with the increase. Case in point, the pistol from the first game.
I was hired to engineer a part the likes of which no man has seen. Now all I do is watch over it like a grizzled sheepdog. My first line of mechanical puppets made the children here coo with wonder. But Ryan thought my vision was immature. Antiquated, he said. This place could have been something magical. But instead, he turned it into a school. No, a cathedral. Dedicated to himself.
I'll make you light as feathers again.
Can I come up to play again, Mr. B?
Jim Dandy, that'll get you in the park. But buying incinerate's gonna cost Adam. It's a sort of genetic goo that lets you rewrite whatever God gave you. The little sisters carry the stuff, as you may recall, so you'll need to locate one. I heard a whisperer near the El Dorado Lounge. Have a look.
And instead of taking the pistol or the Tommy gun, we pick up a freaking machine gun.
Mm-hmm. A nice beauty, a beautiful 50 cal.
I mean, of course we're a big daddy. Of course we're gonna need bigger guns.
Listen up, choppers. Get yourselves hit! No fuck-ups this time! Daddy's home! Take aim! Fire!
Getting this stuff.
Ooh, ran out of ammo.
Hello?
Save the honor.
I'm gonna be using a lot more more money on spending stuff, because at least at the moment I feel like I'm taking a lot more damage than I did in the first game.
Oh, definitely.
You think being a bit, starting off at the game as a big daddy would make you more durable, not less?
What was it? Honestly, they're throwing a lot more at you early on than they did, ever did with Jack, to be honest. So you are durable, but the thing is, you are going up against a lot more things at once.
I am Andrew Ryan. Welcome to Ryan Amusements. Mm-hmm. Please, enjoy the park.
Oh, great. The maniac made a museum about himself. Gene tonic. Sports boost.
Yep, sports boost.
Yep. Now this one is just simply move faster.
Yep.
Where they kind of touch on the creation of Rapture a bit.
Yep.
Wipes sleep from his eyes. Full stop. We begin building here. Refitted for heavy construction, the Olympian returns with a new cargo. A state-of-the-art submersible platform, nicknamed the Sinker. Ferry supplies and workers to the sea floor, fathoms below. After initial supplies have been brought to the sea floor, the platform is permanently moored in the sediment. Massive iron girders are sunk upwards of
feet. It's a shame these ones don't have below the subtitles.
Engineers work to overcome obstacles, such as diamond hard rock, obstinate sea life, and unexpected cavalry.
And they also show you all the depths of the map. So, yeah, the maps here are definitely, at least for this area, definitely feel a fair bit bigger than they were in the first game.
Oh, definitely.
Indeed.
I love the kids in Ms. Englert's third grade class, but boy, I had no idea what I was getting into. Volunteering to chaperone this New Year's sleepover party at Ryan Amusements. Donnie, get down off that exhibit, and I told you, spit out that gum! You'll choke! The kids' parents deserve a night off to enjoy New Year's, but I'm at my wit's end. Donnie, I told you!
Another reason for you to do more hacking of things even when you don't need them. If you get in the blue section, for lack of a better term, a critical hack.
Yep.
You get bonuses.
Yep.
Like free loot from the vending machines.
After the platform is secured, I missed a few builds there.
At an astounding rate. Designed to be the foundation of Rapture, workers toil around the clock to create the metropolis you see today.
Touch turns to shit.
Mean? You're mean, Roger. It was probably your clumsy fat hands that loused it up.
Typical fraud. Stay away from things you don't know nothing about.
Don't speak to me. Mother's pearls, you bastard! Darling!
Let the turret take care of that.
Seems like everybody's on the go these days. Everybody but you. You still haven't experienced Ryan Industries' new spring line of plasmids. Isn't it about time you got caught up? Evolve today.
Oh, sure. Spring line of plasmids.
Of course. Pick your plasmid and evolve.
I still find it interesting when you think about how much of a connection there is between going crazy from being a splicer here in Bioshock and going cyber psycho in Cyberpunk.
Yep. It's all about losing your humanity, more or less. Protectors today and testing.
Somewhere outside the city limits, he simply fucking drugs.
For these men, Rapture has no walls.
Oh, it's more or less taking too many of it at once.
Yep.
Or, well, taking it too quick, there.
Oh, Gil. The lab aides. I remember Gil. Big daddies.
Perhaps there's some genius to that. Bonded pairs, connected by a love that kills.
Let's see. 90 for incinerate, 40 for a health upgrade, and 30 for Evelink.
Evelink's pretty good, but that's for like med kits and all that.
Yep. First, I've got to find me a little sister.
Mm-hmm. Yep, we've already seen the one for this map, and about we were cut off from her.
Mm-hmm. The age-old enemy that prevents you from getting things done when they're the most convenient. Glass.
Yep.
What you want? I deserve.
That splicer sounded more boozed up than chemmed up.
Hmm.
At least with how much he was slurring.
Your kind ain't welcome here. Help! He won't listen. You made me hurt you. Hey, cut it out already.
Yeah, running straight on gives me a great chance to aim it for your head. Safe. Oh, get extra cash for the blue bonus on the safes.
Yep. Yep, it's pretty good.
Hmm.
would have bet on you.
Red Ribbon Brandy. Now, I cannot hear a name like that without my mind flashing to Dragon Ball.
Oh, definitely.
Seems like a bit of a shame that a lot of people seem to forget about the original beginning parts of Dragon Ball before Z.
Yeah.
Seems like a bit of a downright shame that such a chapter is often overlooked.
I mean, fair, but it is still technically the weaker part of that entire series. Or at least it felt the weakest compared to some things from Z. But I mean, at the end of the day, at least Dragon Ball was much better than GT ever was.
Well, with GT, one of the things about GT is that they did that to try and keep Dragon Ball going, even after Toriyama wrapped things up.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Honestly, I did like Super Saiyan 4.
Yeah, that was one thing that they nailed with GT.
Oh yeah, 4 is nice. But still, the rest of it was just a fever dream.
I mean, it is quite good in parts, honestly, look at it. Although, even though a lot of people, the defenders kind of feel like the Super 17 arc was by far the weakest. So it was the most basically felt like a filler arc.
It was short.
Yeah.
Yeah, but at the same time, the evil dragons, they actually had an interesting premise to them. Ooh, heavy rivets.
Ah, you're seeing your third type of rivet now.
I know the surface, Eleanor.
Yep. So you have heavy rivets, you have trap rivets, and you have regular rivets.
Squatting over the embers of Hiroshima. Were the modern world a patient in my care, I would diagnose it suicidal. On perhaps that... Eradicate tyranny at the genetic level. To end sin itself. That is the family. That is our cause.
It's dancing, Daddy! Dancing! This way!
Yeah, and also getting it is a little bit more in-depth here.
She's got a juicy one. But when she starts draining out the atom, the splicers will come running. Be ready before you set her down on that body.
Set up a couple of traps. That should cover at least a small handful.
Just put her right down on that corpse.
Easy, Sinclair. Gotta make sure I'm all prepared. I'd say a whole clip's worth should do for starters.
That is a child of the family. Not a toy for you to exploit and discard. It is fitting that you expire here. One more forgotten curio in Ryan's shrine to the self.
Here they come. Keep the splicers off her now till she's finished, or they'll never give up the hunt.
You ain't her real.
There's also some pretty good tonics for him, enhancing just how much they're actually able to get and how much good little sisters are doing. Pretty neat.
It costs a bit more atom. Yeah, keep it up.
You're right.
Hey, that's one thing a lot of people don't really remember is you can actually pick up your trap rivets.
Yeah, I mean, I don't recall whether or not the trap bolts in from the crossbow was whether that was was collectible or not.
Maybe.
I mean, the ones that existed in the world to begin with, not so much. Especially considering how most of the times, even if you use telekinesis to try and disarm them safely, it still ended up shocking you because of. Little oddities with the positioning.
Yep. Yeah, I don't think those ones were actually retrievable.
Let's buy a few more trap rivets. Besides, I'm probably getting close to the cap on cash.
Fair. We haven't quite gotten to where the big guys are yet, so we can enhance our wallet size.
Mm-hmm. Excuse me.
Ew, you're excused.
For children just like you, because the world above had become unfit for us. But here, beneath the ocean, it is natural to wonder if the danger has passed, if those we left behind will ever come to their senses. So, let us imagine, you and I, what might befall us on the surface.
Great. Andrew Ryan animatronics.
I told you about this one. Make it listen.
Have to wait until this door is unlocked to get what's in here. I'm so used to using a left trigger to ADS. Sometimes I still end up doing it on accident here. Sounds like things are going to hell for this person.
Yep.
Come on, exert yourself. Flatten him out.
It'd definitely be a bit easier to aim for headshots with the ADS.
Troublesome oaf.
One in the chest, one in the dome. There.
Daddy, are you taking me home too?
There's actually fall damage here.
Yippers.
Good to know.
I There was, I believe, in the first game, too.
Never come across it, then. Okay, let's try this again. There we go.
What a mess.
Nay got pew pewed.
On the surface, the farmer tills the soil.
Missed up on a hack and a bunch of sentry bots came down.
But the parasites say no. What was yours is ours. We are a state. We are gone. We demand our share.
Andrew Bloody Ryan. Real class act.
Indeed.
What's on my side?
Now to explore every nook and cranny.
Hello. I don't know why I just wanted to say that. Yeah, I can't remember what you say. So, do you actually have the DLC for this one?
I'd have to go and check. Like after stream.
That's cool.
Okay, I think I got turned around here a bit. Okay, I definitely got turned around. So that's a shortcut here. That's where this leads. Hey! You had to attack while you were standing in the water, did you?
Of course.
They've been had. I will not have my city swindled by the parasite, whatever its guise. It is time, I think, to call Sinclair.
Hmm.
angel.
I've been rationing my supplies ever since the park got cut off from the rest of Rapture. Gotta stay strong. I'm holed up in this workshop, surrounded by those wailing brats, trying to beat their way in. They want my food, my guns. They want it all. But I got a plan. Gotta fix up the transport sub that's been rusting in the maintenance bay. Then I'm gonna get the hell out of this hole. These animals want Rapture? They can have it.
Okay. I think that's all the prep work I can do, minus setting some traps. As much as I love, some of these old-timey music, I do notice that it means that every single Bioshock stream that I've uploaded to YouTube or archives has ended up being copyright flagged.
Cheers.
Gotta love the YouTube system.
Gotta love the algorithm.
Okay, I've used all of my trap rivets, so that should help a fair bit. Okay, little one.
I do not hate you, Delta. Indeed, I care for you in equal measure to any other sentient creature. But I cannot sacrifice 1,000 of my children for one rebellious son.
These words, sinner! Ignore me! I'm trying my best!
Meet the leader!
Quite well.
All right, Chief. We've almost got enough Adam
indeed,
now.
You just
to
have
get
a,
the rest,
you only have
you'll
a
have
few
to take care
holes
of that
in
little
sign.
Sister. There should be one of the air vents they favor in the workshop. Bring her down there.
Yeah, all those trap rivets and the turret definitely help to curtail the incursion. Now to the loot. And of course, making sure the health station was properly hacked also helped.
Yeah, that does help. Now remember, Eleanor, always steal from people and hack whatever you can. Yeah. I don't know why I'm just pitching Nay Big Dad just walking around like saying all this to Eleanor or something like that and just to himself, I am such a good parent.
Yes, I have not been there for 10 years, but in my defense, for those 10 years, I was dead.
Yes. I'm just making up for lost time. Just teaching my daughter the proper ins and outs.
Okay, let's switch to the machine gun a bit until I can get some more rivets.
Always carry a hammer space on you, Eleanor. You never know how else you're going to carry all your guns.
It is an incredibly useful tool.
Indeed. Hey, Lars, can we get a portable hammer space or a bag of... I guess that would be a bag of holding or a portable hole, wouldn't it?
Yeah, me thinks Orisk may have slipped away for a bit.
Me too.
The parasite makes nothing for itself. Its only tools are taxes.
Yeah, it's probably good to put your electricity away if you're handling electronics, you think about it. Honestly, I thought those were paint buckets for a minute.
Of the ego, Eleanor. Under Ryan, the voices of
there's a lot of things I like about Bioshock Team 101. I don't like that you can't really backtrack.
Already they grow weary of struggling against one another in fruitless competition. Observe the bent backs, the drawn faces. Ryan promised us more, they seem to say. In what shall we now believe? And Eleanor, it is our task to answer.
Invests the power of his mind in a single miraculous idea and naturally begins to rise above his fellows. But the parasites say no. Discovery must be regulated. It must be controlled and finally surrendered.
On that subject, Ryan, a certain degree of regulation is necessary as a safety measure. I mean, have there been instances of people trying to come up with new medicines and then finding a bunch of oh yeah, it'll do this, this, and that, and there's that long, long list of possible side effects, which include death.
Yeah, it'll cure you, but it'll also do this. This. It'll cure you, but it's gonna make you grow a third nipple.
Yeah. Okay, so I either have to sit for however long it takes me to get over over my cold with runny nose, watery eyes, and deal with just that, which is an annoyance, or risk this long list of things that could potentially happen, which are all, which many of which sound a lot worse than just having a runny nose.
Frame his ideals in an image to challenge his audience and make his vision immortal. But the parasites say, no, your art must serve the cause. Your ideals endanger the people.
Ryan has definitely has some baggage.
No, you think?
Well, he's dead now.
Yeah, fair enough.
Hello? We were in the middle of something!
Yeah. Hello? What was it? 4 years ago?
Lacking its own ingenuity, the parasite fears the visionary. What it cannot plagiarize, it seeks to censor. What it cannot regulate, it seeks to ban. Rapture was founded on an idea, and here they are held inviolate.
Hey. It can be a little bit hard to listen to Ryan preach on sometimes.
Yeah.
Twist the lies, church and government, believing themselves masters of the system. But the parasites said, no. The child has a duty. He will go to war and die for the nation.
Mm-hmm. I think we can tell. We can figure out what's gonna happen on this tape.
Two weeks at my last count. 2 weeks since we were trapped in this rotten park. I haven't been eating. The children need all the supplies we've got left. Need them more than I do. I don't know what's gonna happen. I can feel myself getting weaker. The children have noticed the condition I'm in, of course. What will happen once I'm gone? I'll be all alone.
Okay, probably should go back to where it wants me to go.
Now, Tannenbaum would have you turn that sister human again. You'll get just enough Adam for our purposes, and the girls will likely try to repay you somehow. But Rapture's a high-stakes town, son, and she is a jackpot. You just have to be willing to take it all. You'll harvest more Adam than the price of one plasmid, so the rest is gravy. Think about it. Down here, it's your survival or hers.
As tempting as that offer is, Sinclair, I'm not going to take it. That was close. Yeah, I just managed to get that safe unlocked in the end.
Nice.
And a clever little trick here. If you come into this after just playing Bioshock 1, you'll probably still have the button assignments for them memorized. But you would remember that in Bioshock 1, X was harvest and Y was rescue. Here, they're reversed.
Jeez.
So if you just out of reflex hit the Y button because I'm using controller, hit the Y button out of practiced habit from rescuing them and from the previous game, you'll end up freaking out as you find yourself accidentally harvesting them.
Cheers.
So, cheeky.
Well, our tin man had a heart all along. Personally, I call that a liability, but you have enough Adam now. Barely. Head to the Hall of the Future and splice up with Incinerate.
One rescued little sister. Many more to come. So backtrack and grab that medkit now. But yeah, that is also a point that if I remember correctly about this game, you don't really have the ability to backtrack as much as you did. Because it looked like I've never really tried to backtrack in the first game because I was just so ridiculous. I was, for the most part, ridiculously thorough. So the only thing I could potentially backtrack to was to get past levels Gatherer's Gardens to see if the health and Adam upgrades there were, whether or not they were truly just locked to those specific ones that could potentially go and raise my stats up higher. But I don't think you can, because with the way you travel in this one, I'm not sure if you can backtrack. All the more reason to be thorough and try and get anything while you can in your first run through.
Jeez.
Another weapon state, power to the people station.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see, machine gun gets damage, recoil, and ricochet upgrade. I'm gonna go hit up the rivet gun clip size. I wanna fully upgrade the rivet gun so I can make it more of a workhorse.
It's this pseudo-legal firm he set up to take problems Ryan doesn't want to admit he has, and make them go away.
Yeah.
I could fill 40 now I can hold
72 rivets.
Stories about this fella, if he wasn't paying me not to. And he's got work for me, right? I ask what, and he flashes me these $1,000 Steinman teeth saying this job will, quote, change history.
Okay, stocked up on some rivets.
Hmm.
some auto hack darts.
Always useful.
I'm trying to remember. I think I might have passed something. Well, I want to be certain. Go and double check. Nope. No. That's just a plain locked door. Next upgrade, I'll be able to get the heated rivets, which should hopefully help really raise up what I can do with this gun.
I think the rivet gun was since I know you can't fully upgrade all your guns in this one. The rivet was one I did.
So you can't upgrade all your weapons in this game then?
Nope, I believe it's like 16, I think, or you get like 14. Power to the people stations, and I think there's 18 upgrades. Let me check that again.
So gotta be strategic a bit with what I choose to spend my upgrades on.
Yep, there's 14 power to the people stations, but there's 18 possible upgrades in total. It is impossible to backtrack to earlier levels, so yeah, make sure you get everything before you leave a level.
Unable to provide for itself, the need of the parasite grows until war is made to justify it. Your parents brought you to Rapture, where you need never fear the parasites again. So you see, there is no place for you on the surface, but you may bring the world to you. If you know someone who belongs in Rapture, write a letter to the Ryan Industries mailroom, and you never know. The next new face might be familiar.
So that song that would play at the when you launch the first game is the Rapture National Anthem.
Facility is vital to the preservation of secrecy in Rapture, but seeing myself transformed into that lurching, waxen nightmare, do children truly respond to this? Still, I spoke to a young man exiting the park after the grand opening, asking him what, if anything, he had learned here. He said his chores didn't seem so as long as Mother wouldn't send him to the surface.
Come on, choppers! Tear this place down!
Yeah, it definitely feels like the splicers here are just higher in number, just a lot more aggressive. Ooh, booze hound! Finally, I can do the drinky drinky!
Indeed.
And get so much earlier here.
The question is, do you really want to teach Eleanor this? Let me get... Eleanor, don't watch Daddy now.
I have a dating tip for you, Jimbo. It'll get you out of that Lonely Hearts Club for good. This scheme works 100% of the time, guaranteed. First, find some Betty and take her to Ryan Amusements. Then, you go to the gift shop, buy her a teddy bear. This is key. I ain't kidding around. Then, you buy her a ticket on Journey to the Surface. As soon as you hit that first scare, bingo! Tunnel of Love.
Okay, now that I got those security doors open, I'm gonna make one last trip because that one thing, look, that one door back down the ride may be open now. Again, since we can't backtrack, gotta make sure to be thorough. Another shortcut. Neat.
So you would drain the people of their life's blood. Rapture is a body, Delta. I am the voice, and Big Sister is the hand. When Rapture speaks of you, it says only this. Sleep now. Your day is done.
Not if you don't visit the gap. So, first things first for sure, incinerate.
Are you?
Light up enemies to 1,000 degrees. Warning.
Sweet free needle.
Let's see, and I've got 70, so enough to get both the health upgrade and the Eve link.
That was one of these smile things.
Say, Tom here is having a romantic evening with a gal.
See, there's no such thing as spontaneous combustion. It's just with a snap of your fingers. Where with Inferno.
Oh, a party. But this party just skids. Carl needs a light for his cigar, and no one can help him.
There's a second one in here that has more stuff. That's An Eve upgrade, a gene tonic slot, armored shell, careful hacker, and extra nutrition. If I had gone harvested, I probably would have had enough to get the Eve upgrade as well as the gene tonic, possibly the armored shell too. However,
you're not a monster.
No, I'm not.
I'm not a monster. Proceeds to set people on fire with a thought and drill people to the. Well, I guess in your defense, they kind of deserved it.
And in a lot of those cases, it is self-defense. And that sounded like an angry big sister.
I wonder if you can make free toast now.
Stocked up on Eve hypos.
Fix your robot friend. wouldn't it be better to hack that first?
Ah, crap baskets, I didn't know if it wasn't hacked.
Fortunately, delay is a thing.
I thought I'd gotten it already.
There's also a robot,
Are you talking about the turret? Hacked that the first time I came here.
Actually, it looked like a drone. Oh, I thought that was a drone. Look, I'm not that blind. I swear I thought I saw a helicopter blade on it.
That hurt. Didn't even have time to pop the med kit. Where are you? Where are you? Come on, show yourself.
Son, not even a big sister can keep you down. Well, come on back and melt the ice and we can say goodbye to this two-bit carny ride.
I got 40 atom off of her. Probably not enough, enough for her. Let me go back and double check. Yeah, waste not, whatnot after all. Oh, it is enough either for the Eve upgrade or the gene tonic slot. But not both. I feel like I should spend the 40 on the Eve upgrade because if it's anything like before, the tonic slots do kind of carry over until you get them all. But the stat upgrades might not. Plus, more Eve means I can use my plasmids more. Okay. Yep. banking on the tonic slots being the ones that carry over.
James was the only man I ever loved, and now it's like he never even came to Rapture. He heard me sing at the limbo room, came up all bashful. He liked hearing songs about what it's really like to live in this town. I think he's been trying to organize folks against Ryan. And now he's gone, and I'm here, singing Rise, Rapture, Rise. Scared to death they're gonna come for me.
Outstanding, sport. You're proving to be quite a windfall. Now just open the train tunnel from the security booth there, and I'll come out and jump on. I like to look a man in the eye when I give him my word. You and me, kid, we're going places.
I had thought you some golem of Sinclair's, brought here to hold Rapture's arms while he rifles through her pockets. But no, you are aware of your plight. Who, I wonder, would be so cruel to force a mirror on a man with no face?
Lamb was waiting for us. Come out shooting and start the train.
Hey, bolt from on high.
Since this door is open, check here for any more loot.
Andrew Ryan. He reckoned the free market was some kind of holy spirit gonna lead us all over the rainbow. And I reckon it's a big fat hooker too dim to spot a wooden nickel. So old Andy went and became his own ghost, and I whittled nickels till I made a mint.
Okay, I think that's just about all I can find here, unless I missed something.
Yeah, I can see that.
So, time to move on, then we can wrap up the stream, because that's two full chapters.
Nice.
And even then, here they're saying, warning, you're about to leave this level. Make sure you've done everything you want here before proceeding past this point. Basically telling you flat out, yeah, you're not going to be able to come back. So if you left anything behind, it's gone for good.
Let's see, looks like you got your two powered people machines done on your rivet gun. So yeah, you're doing pretty good now.
Oh, welcome back, Ross.
I've been here. No worries.
Oh. I say, because I think what were we talking about? We mentioned something earlier and you didn't respond.
Yeah, I might have been dozing off there.
Yeah, you were asking Orsk about Hammerspace /
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we were talking about Hammerspace and stuff. I'm like, yeah, do we like bags of holding or portable holes and stuff?
Yeah, that's a thing.
Yeah.
Attention. Subject Delta.
Oh, I hope I don't know if Scorpion knows you can make a bomb out of those too. Is
suspended until don't he is found. Tell him.
Remember, the enemy is alone. We are the family.
Fair enough.
But yeah. That I think Lab's is a nice, trying to box a nice us in, spot, kid. A spot
this
to
is
wrap
a goddamn citywide lockdown. To keep the train moving, you need the security override key from the local governor.
It's a hell of a bomb too.
She kicked me out of my own hotel down here, the Sinclair Deluxe.
It's a nasty one.
Find her and get that key.
Now do a quick manual save. And a nice little option, if you choose to quit to the main menu, it asks us if you want to save your current game before exiting. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's another nice quality of life improvement that they put in this game. that was good. A nice first stream for the new year.
Good game to do it to.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and puts me one step closer to being able to finally play Bioshock Infinite. I'm going to admit now, I have been spoiled on certain things for Bioshock Infinite.
Fair enough.
Yeah, because it's the internet. It's really hard to avoid spoilers, especially when a game gets to a certain point of it's that old. And since I for the longest time was in the mindset that since I couldn't afford it when it came out, that I was never going to play it, so I didn't exactly go out of my way to try to avoid spoilers because I figured I wasn't going to play it. I've tried dabbling in it a little bit when I could get like demos and whatnot, but yeah, some of the big things have been spoiled for me, but I still want to play it. I still want to experience it for myself. Because even if I know some of the things that are coming, I don't know all the things that are coming, and I still want to experience the journey.
I can agree with that 10,000%.
So, yeah, we still have plenty of adventure left at the bottom of the sea before we have to take things up above the clouds. Yeah, but that is an interesting evolution, is how you go and top Bioshock and Rapture. Well, you literally top it by going all the way up into the sky.
Yep.
And then we don't know if it really is related, Judas or something. Then you go to fucking space. Which is also apparently, I guess, also reversing, because I think System Shock, which Bioshock is based off of, took place in space, I think.
Yeah.
So, in its own way, a return to form.
Indeed.
But now it's that time, once again, to see if there's anyone streaming, and it looks like what's become one of the go-to streamers to raid, Fiora is up and running. And make sure I spell it correctly. Because, yeah, the raid ain't gonna work if I try to send it to Fiora the Tan Girl or Fiora the Tamk Girl.
Ah, yes, the Tan Girl.
That's still. Thanks to everyone. Thanks to you. words. Why do they... Ah! Even when I'm blurping, I'm blurbing.
Hugs.
Whee! So, thank you to everyone who came to join the call. Thank you, Orsk, nickname Carl. It's always a pleasure to have my friends join me on these streams.
Always a pleasure to be with you.
And thank you to everyone who came by to watch. Oh, and Alvarna too, even though Alvarna seems to have left. But until next time, I hope you all take care now. See you next time. Bye-bye.
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 All right, and the raid is good to go. Launching in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bye now.
Bye again.